Hello students, today I am going to teach you about map. It is the first lesson of your syllabus. This lesson you have already read in 6th class. So I will explain this in this class also. So first of all, what is map? You all know, you must be knowing what is map. A map is a symbolic representation or a drawing of the earth's surface or a part of it drawn on a flat surface according to a scale. The word map is derived from two Latin words, mappa means sheet and mundi mean of the world. So this was the meaning of map. Now the types of maps on the basis of scale. So you must be knowing what is scale. So scale is the ratio of the distance between the map and the distance on the ground. So it is the ratio of distance on the map to the ground. So there are two types of maps, that is large scale maps and small scale maps. So large scale maps are those maps which show small area in great detail. These are called as large scale maps. Second is the small scale map. Small scale maps show large area in less detail. So the small scale map that contains the country map or the state map or the world map. But large scale map shows the small area in great detail. So it is it contains a map of local area, that is cadastral map and the topographic map. So in this chapter we will discuss about the topographical maps in detail. So what is topographical maps? This topography you will learn in 10th class in detail, that contains 20 marks. So this is very important topic, but in this class you will only know the introduction of topographical map. So topographical maps are commonly known as a topo sheet or topo map. Topographical maps are those maps that are based on large scale. So these are large scale maps. So they show both natural and man-made features of the earth. Topographical maps of India are prepared by the Department of Survey of India. These maps are based on scale of 1 inch, half inch and quarterly inch respectively to a mile. These maps show the shape of the land surface as well as the location of streams, lakes, roads, cities, sand dunes, the direction of the rivers and the settlement area. So these maps show a particular area in great detail. In India, the British established the Survey of India Department in 1767. Major James Rennell was appointed as the first Surveyor General of India. Now, significance of topographical maps. They show both the natural and man-made features of the earth. They provide information to engineers for building canals, roads, etc. These maps are also very useful in the field of defense and navigation. They are also helpful in studying the geology of a place. Now, important facts regarding the history of map making. How the map making started in the world. The first map on a flat surface was drawn by Gerardus Mercator in 1569. Gerardus Mercator is best known for his work in cartography. So you must be knowing what is cartography. Cartography is the science of making map, and the person who makes a map is called as cartographer. Then Claudius Ptolemy was the first person who provided Geographia, a book of collection of maps, in the 2nd century AD. You must be knowing about Atlas. So he made the Atlas. The oldest map is still preserved in the form of a small baked clay tablet. It is more than 4000 years old. Now some importance of a map. Maps are the most effective means of communicating data. These can be represented through general, thematic, physical, or topographical maps. General maps portray the geographical phenomenon on a map. Thematic map shows a particular distribution theme, such as forest, wildlife, and monuments. Then that is particular theme. Then topographical maps show natural features, man-made features, and cultural features. Now, some components of a map by which you can recognize the particular symbol or particular direction or for what purpose that map is made. So these components are first the title, the heading of the map, then the direction by which we can know in which part that is asked, in which part that thing is, then the measuring distance, how can we measure the distance between two places, that is from Delhi to Mumbai or from Delhi to Darbhanga or from Dunar to Alalpatti, how can we measure that direction distance that can be known by the map. Then the scale. So scale is also very important components of map by which we can know the distance between the two things or two places on a map. First is the title. It is necessary to identify the map. For example, the title of the map, that is India soil or India political or India physical, that is written at the top right hand corner or left hand corner of the map. Then second is the direction, that is the cardinal points. You must be knowing the four main directions. These directions are called as cardinal points. So the four main directions are north, south, east, west. So without direction, we never reach our destination. So if we have to go to from the Donar Chowk to Kathalwari, then we have to know in which direction Kathalwari is from Donar. So direction is very important. Direction is a relative term and is expressed in relation to a given point. For example, Hyderabad is towards the south of Delhi. So if you have seen the map of India, then you must be knowing that Hyderabad is in south. So there are four main directions which I already taught, and four other directions, that these are called as intermediate direction, that is between the main direction, that is northwest, northeast, southwest, southeast, for accuracy in map study. Now we will discuss about the importance of direction. So with reference to the direction, we study the phenomena of celestial body. Celestial body means where that planet is, where that star is, or where that particular celestial body is located. We come to know about the sunrise and the sunset, that sun rises in the east and sunset in the west. Now, the scale. It is a measuring line which shows the relation of the distance between two places on a map to their actual distance on land. Definition of scale: a ratio between a distance measured on a map and a corresponding distance on land connecting the two points. You can write this definition in your notebook also. Now, types of scale. I taught you about the types of scale in the previous also. Now, distance can be measured by means of scale in three ways. That is verbal scale or a statement. Second is by numerical fraction or representative fraction. And third is graphic or linear scale. Now, first is the verbal scale. In this method, the scale is expressed in words. Example: 1 centimeter on the map represent 50 kilometer on the ground. This method is not very popular as it does not give the accurate measurement. Now second is the representative fraction or RF. The numerical fraction method is also called as representative fraction because it is shown in ratio. This scale can be used by any country in the world. For example, if the RF or representative fraction is 1:50,000, it would mean that 1 centimeter on the map represents 50,000 centimeter on the ground. This scale can be converted into any unit. So this method of distance is popular and it is used by many countries. Now the third method is graphic scale or linear scale. This scale represents the relationship between a particular distance on the map and the actual distance on the earth. So this scale is shown in graphical way in a line, so which I have made in the this also. So I will show you that page also when in this video. For example, linear scale, that is 6 kilometer. The linear scale is the most accurate method of measuring distances on the map. Now you can see the graphical scale or linear scale. Here it is 6 kilometer. Now in this you can see from -1 to 0, it is divided into 1000 meter or 1 kilometer. So this 2 centimeter in this graph is equal to 1 kilometer, which you can see here it is written. The scale to which it is drawn is 2 centimeter is equal to 1 kilometer. Now significance of map study and colors in a lesion. So maps are very important as they serve as a storehouse of information. We can know about many things in map. If you have to know about the wildlife, if we have to know about the physical feature, if we have to know about the monuments, if we have to know about the cities, towns, if we have to know about the capitals, we can know easily from the map. We can find out the destination by using GPS. The full form of GPS is Global Positioning System, and GIS, that is Geographical Information System. The topographical maps portray the natural features, man-made features and cultural features using appropriate colors and symbols. So I will show you the colors which is shown in the map with this table. Now you can see here yellow color which is shown in the map, that tells us about the cultivable land, plateaus, deserts and plains. Now green color which is shown in the map, that shows forest area or lowland areas. White color, that shows rocky area or bad land, hence uncultivable land. So yellow color shows cultivable land and white color shows uncultivable land. Now blue color also you see in the map. So mostly blue color, you must be knowing that blue color is for water bodies. So all the water bodies is shown with blue color, that is lakes, ponds, water bodies, that is perennial streams, perennial line wells or rivers, that is shown in blue color. Now brown color shows the contour lines, their heights and relief features like mountains. Black color, that shows dry streams and surveyed trees. Red color shows permanent huts, settlements and cities. Now about symbol. A symbol is a mark, sign or word that indicates the object or idea shown on the map. For example, blue line shows river or stream, red octagon show symbol for stop. It is most important feature of the map. It is shown by different colors, pictures and lines. A list of symbols or signs are given at the bottom of the map, which is also called as लीजन.
नाउ यू कैन सी डिफरेंट सिंबल्स एंड साइंस इन दिस पेज. यू कैन सी टू रेड ब्लॉक्स आर देयर दैट शोज परमानेंट हर्ट. द टू स्क्वायर बॉक्सेस आर देयर विच शो टेम्पररी हर्ट विच इज विदाउट द रेड कलर. देन द क्रॉस इज देयर विच शोज डेजर्टेड टाउन. Now there are different types of settlements, that is nucleated, linear, scattered or dispersed. That is according to the number of people that live there. So if many people are living together and if the population is more, then that is called as nucleated settlement. That is mostly seen in the near the railway station or confluence, a quarry, or near a mine or industrial site. So this nucleated settlement is seen in this region. Now linear settlement, that is seen mainly in the both side of the river, or it is seen on both side of the road. So this may be dhabas, hotels and shops. Then scattered settlement are the settlement which is away from each other. When the huts and hutments or the houses are away from each other, then this is called as scattered settlement. Now you can see different signs and symbols in this, that is fort, tower, antiquities, then temple, that is written in Hindi, mandir, then church, mosque, idgah, tomb, graves, then it is also written in letters, that is if it is post office then PO is written, if it is telegraph office then TO is written, then for telegraph lines the dots and the square is written, given in colors, then PTO, that is for post and telegraph, PS is for police station, DB is for dak bungalow, IB is for inspection bungalow, RH is for rest house, CG is for camping ground, CH is for circuit house, RS is for railway station. And there are other symbols also which you can see and you can write in notebook. So you can see the political boundaries here in this symbol, that is for international you can see the rectangle is there and dots are there, which is filled with black color. Then state boundaries are also there, that is also shown in the same way, but that is thinner than the international boundary. Then state boundaries are there, which is shown with the cross and that dash. Then the districts are there, which is shown with dash with some gap. Then tehsil is there, which is shown in dots. Then forest boundaries are there. Then surveyed houses are there, then unlocated, then village. Then you can see the transport and communication roads are shown in two parallel lines. Then the unmetalled roads are shown with the gap between the two lines. Then the pack track is shown, then car track, footpath, then the railway line, broad gauge, meter gauge, narrow gauge, then the different types of drainage pattern is shown, stream, river, then canal, then river with island and rocks, river dry with water channel. So these are very important because of the topography which you will learn in your senior class, that is 10th, because it contains 20 marks. Now you can also see these symbols which you have to remember, and you have to write, you have to draw some of the symbols and write about it in your notebook. At least you have to write 20 symbols in your notebook with the proper diagram, and also you have to explain that whatever is written in the book.